Hey guys, welcome back to Blood Will Tell. Today we are starting up the game proper, like Chapter 1. Here we go. No more of this prologue nonsense in full color. Oh, Yaki showing off some leg there. Wonderful. Yeah, this is gonna get really cool. Eh? Now what is that noise, viewers? What? Oh man. I hate this guy. He's freaky. Hey! What the rocks, you dingus? No, really, though. This guy scares me. It's his abnormally large head. I know mine's big, but his is really big, viewers. God damn. Alright, let's be quiet. Because I don't want this thing to hear me at all. Lay down, Doro! Yep. There you go.
If it's free, I'll take it.
Bamboo thicket. Just again. So shiny.
Okay. That was needlessly weird. Uy.
Hey, Yaki. Did you see that creep last night?
Yeah. You looked so scared, I thought you'd start crying.
You think I was scared of that freak? If I gave him a nasty look, he'd have run away crying. He was probably an amateur thief. He's probably headed for that village over there. We should go check it out.
Okay, fair enough. So, we have an objective now. We're gonna head over to the village and see if we can't track down that horrible, horrible fiend. Ugh, that was weird. And yeah, as you can see here, we can control Doro to a certain extent. We can send her to attack to pick up items. Just hold circle button. We yell at her. And yeah.
Gotcha.
Get some items! No, no. We're gonna have her just fight stuff, because believe it or not, she's actually a pretty damn good fighter.
Gotcha.
First thing I should say, kinda messed up the recording again. So I started the game all the way over. Just for you guys, it was only like 15 minutes, it really wasn't that bad, just running through. But I do apologize, there may be some slight discrepancies, rest assured, that's not gonna happen ever again. I'm gonna use multiple save files and not be a complete jackass. Yeah, because I totally saved and... we had to scrap the recording, let's just put it that way. Oh, that was miserable. But yeah, the game is so much nicer in full color, isn't it? Looks really cool. Oh, and there are these green orbs everywhere. I didn't really describe them. I was hoping we would get a tutorial. In fact, we may still yet, but I'm just going to go ahead and describe them. Basically, there's a small little circle above my health gauge that you can see there. It's empty right now. When we collect 100 of these green balls, fuck yourself, that circle will be full. It will be green. And when it is full, when our health gauge totally depletes, we will use up one of these circles to fully restore our health. Basically, they're the equivalent of extra lives in this game. Hey, you are not blocking my sword arms, buddy, are you? Yeah, it was. Get out of here. There you go. If you want these guys, what? Shooting destructo discs at me. Fuck off. Dororo punch. She's so awesome. Sword arms leveled up. That's not bad. Oh, we're getting frame drops again. I guess it does not like this at all. But yeah, you see, like when they're laying on the ground. Takes a little while to die. If you like slash at them, they'll just go ahead and die. It speeds things up, and you can see if they drop any items a lot quicker. Okay, what is this guy doing? Jumping around like an idiot. Off you go, buddy. Seriously, get out of here. There he goes. Okay, we're leveling up our left arm a lot more than our right, which is a little strange. Oh, and I left an enemy back here. Whoops. Yeah, I think, and I'm not 100%. I think that our light attacks work out our left arm a lot more, and then our heavy ones work out our right? I'm totally speculating there, and I'm honestly probably totally wrong. But that's how it feels. Now, I don't need to use my spirit attack, man. I know how it works. Adoro, like, messed that guy up all by herself. It's incredible. Okay, moving on, and up here. Whoa! Just spewing everywhere, aren't you? That is actually really damn gross. Alright, get out of here, buddy. Drill him in the back. Doro punch. Yeah, she just punched the fuck out of that guy. This kid is amazing, I'm telling you. Alright, off you go. She is definitely a nice little thief, if ever I saw one. Well, she's not really thieving, is she? She's just kind of punching the fuck out of demons. Ow! What can you do? Alright, stab this guy. Oh, and one other thing that is different from our previous save file is I actually found a sword the last run. It was just kind of laying there, so I picked it up. Probably shouldn't have. But rest assured, it's not impressive at all. We have an unmarked blade equipped right now, and we picked up a worn blade. So you can see it is weaker. So, oh, no real point to it. Level 2, level 3. Our blades will be sorted by, you know, their level, their overall strength. And we only have Sparrow's Flight right now, which is our spirit attack. Oh, I forgot about that. You actually see the experience gauges on our swords on the inventory menu. Not bad. All right. Out we go. Let's move on. Oh, and I... God damn it. I told myself I was going to look up what those stats were. That I couldn't remember what they were in the last video, and I totally forgot. So, remind me next video, I'm going to pull out my instruction booklet and look it up. Yeah, I do actually have the PS2 game, you know, full game, instruction book, all that shit. It's very nice. Gotta say, I've always really liked this game. When did I get... I'm trying to remember when I got it. I used to work at a game store, and I remember this coming in, and it just entranced me. I checked it out, basically the equivalent of renting it, and loved it, so I bought it. Not really well known, though, which is unfortunate, because, yeah, it's damn good. Right, off you go, buddy. Gotta lay off that helicopter spin, man, but it's like my favorite move. It's so strong. And this guy doesn't know what the hell's going on. Get out of here, bud. There he goes. Alright, let's move on upwards here, then. A little save point. We don't need to worry about that. Again, reminding myself, multiple saves, Alan. Please, God. It's nice, like, I never use save states when I'm doing, like, my old games, emulator stuff. But I do use save states for backing up my progress in case something happens with the recording. And here, I'm not going to have that leisure, which is unfortunate. But, you know, we're going to learn together, viewers. We're going to figure out how to be awesome, masterful console Let's Players. It's so goddamn stupid. Alright, moving up here. Climbing up this mountain. Nice little area. Again, this game is very visually pleasing. If not a little frightening, honestly. Alrighty. And up we go. Oh, that fiend. Rather, that regular-ass demon snuck up on me there. Kind of scared me. Doro, how about you punch this guy? Punch him out. Oh, shit. She just kicked the hell out of that zombie. That was amazing. Doro, you have earned your rice for tonight, young lady. Alright, scaling this mountainside. Something that makes me a little nervous. Heights, man, I'm telling you. What? Not sure what happened there. That was a little strange. Alright, zombie, get the hell out of my face, please. Yeah, there we go. Now we're just going to keep climbing up here. Still have a lot of enemies to contend with. Just following the yellow arrows, it's still fairly linear at this point, so not much to worry about. These guys in the grass, they're like, it's just grass with like a tail on it. They always beat the piss out of me. I don't know why. I hate them. Hate them to death. This attack really reminds me of Sonic for some reason. If I jump and then just hit the heavy attack, I do like that vertical slash there. It's pretty damn awesome. Anything in here? A cannon shot, not too bad. You totally... What? I accidentally equipped my... I always think L2 is the cannon, but no. R2 is my cannon. L2 is my nice sword here. Oh god, I'm not near as good with this thing, am I? But I can still do like quick attacks with it, which is pretty cool. Oops. Check this out.
Back to the darkness.
Yeah. Now that I have vocal cords, I actually like taunt enemies when I kill them with that. Definitely gonna stick with the arm swords. God, I love them. The only reason I really like equipping a regular sword is for the moment where I pull out the double swords again. Seriously, that animation. Look at this shit. Bam! It's so badass. Never mind that Doro's like having to follow me around picking up my arm shells. It's kind of weird. Whatever. Get these birds out of my face. This part really scares me. But you can't fall off, which is really nice. Even then, though, the heights, man. I'm telling you. I'm going to fall in. There's another save point there. We're just going to skip past that. And break this. Actually, oh, wait. Don't really need to. A spirit up. That just gives us more of our spirit gauge, if I remember correctly. Oh, and I got, like, an attack up a while ago. That, when you get that, you actually glow red. We weren't able to see it because we were just still perceiving things with our mind's eye. Yeah, you glow red, and if you find like a defense up, you'll glow blue. And you'll just know when it expires, basically judging on when you stop glowing. Alright, buddies, get out of here. Spamming the helicopter spin. Oh, yeah. And Dororo can like throw rocks and shit, too. She's fucking cool, man, I'm telling you. Also, like, she can't die. She can run out of stamina, but it'll just knock her out for a little while. You really don't need to worry about her health if you're controlling Hyakkimaru. Yeah, spoiler alert. If you're controlling her, yeah, you definitely need to be careful. Looks like we had the village up there. I didn't really comment on it, but what can you do? And yeah, here we are. Let's see what's going on here in this.
But seriously, what kind of thief goes around ringing a bell like that?
Nasty village.
Yeah, you've got a good point.
You say you saw a man ringing a bell?
You saw the troll?
These two saw the troll!
Who the heck is the troll?
Men, quickly! We must bring them to Mistress Yudai!
Yeah!
Mistress Yudai, huh?
We haven't done anything!
That's very true. Chapter 1, You Die. Yeah, that's her name. Put that one together, viewers. Have you put it together yet? That's her. She's a freaky mamma jamma. She's actually paler than... Well, okay, she's not paler than me, but very close. Oh god, I'm pale. Wow, look at her. Ew, no, she's bound my arms.
I have been told that you two have met the troll. Quite unlucky for you. However, I cannot undo your bonds just yet.
What's going on? Why can't you let us go?
The troll is, of course, not human. It is a monster, an evil spirit. He would have spoken to one of you. To which of you did he speak? What did he say to you? I must know what he said.
I didn't hear anything.
How about you, sir?
Don't know.
That is impossible. If you do not answer my question, I cannot release your bonds. Now tell me the truth. There is nothing to be gained by lying to me.
Said I don't know.
Yucky!
You leave me no choice. I shall put you in the well room like all the others.
The well room, huh? Oh, God.
Come on, Yucky! What did the troll say to you? You can tell me.
Quiet.
Oh god, not looking forward to this.
Something's coming from the well.
Holy shit! What? Look at the size of this thing.
It's gonna eat us! We're gonna be demon food!
This just keeps getting better and better.
Yeah, pro tip, if you want to capture Hyakkimaru, don't tie him up by his detachable arms. You dumb lady. Okay, so... The Scourge. Wow, look at this Oh god, look at this thing. He looks super mad. Alright, he's got like a bandage for a tail. Yeah, that's his weakness. I did remember that correctly. Unfortunately, he likes to sweep it around like the Dickens, which is really annoying. Wow. Very aggressive, this guy. Okay, careful. Land a few hits here. Just keep doing my little vertical spin dash. That seems... Or slash. Spin dash. Again, I'm thinking of Sonic. It's very effective. And I wonder if I can't get like a mortar shot off on this prick. Mm-mm. Step off, bro. Dororo. Need you to punch him in the face. Come on, lady. Grow up. Wow. She is super brave. Not gonna lie about it. Alright. No, I hit the L2 again. R2 is mortar, Alan. Come on. Let's fucking... Bam! Blast this guy for massive damage. Yeah, that worked pretty well. Now he's going up here. Screw off! Where are you going? You're climbing on the wall there. Oh, that's freaky. Okay, you're gonna have to stop eventually. Here we go. Just laying into him, aiming at the tail. Taking lightning on the chin. That's what I do best. Again, shit. We don't have to worry too much about these early bosses. But we should still be pretty careful. Whoop, okay. Drop some ammo here. Damn, I was totally jumping out of the way of that. Dororo's about to die, but again, not something we really need to worry about too much. Okay, I can't get near his tail, so I'm about to just go for the face here. How does that sound? Oh, I totally blocked that. Okay. Well then, fine. You want to play dirty? Let's play dirty, you bitch. Eat machine gun in the face. Yeah. Oh no, I missed. Probably shouldn't have held on to it that long, but spray and pray, that's my philosophy. Spray and pray. Whoa. Eh?
Yaki, what the heck was that?
A demon. But I've never encountered one so powerful before. It might be a demon that stole one of my body parts. I cut it pretty deep. I need to go into the well to see if it's dead.
Oh god, that's a brilliant idea.
Hang on just a second. Leave it to me. This
what?
Is what I do best.
So yeah, instead of Hyakkimaru going down there...
Bones! Lots of them! They were probably sent here to get eaten too!
We're gonna send a child. God.
That damn woman meant to kill us.
You don't say.
She never expected us to get out of this place alive. I wonder how many people she has tied up here and fed to that demon. But why is she so intent on killing anyone who saw the troll? There must be some sort of connection between Yudai and the troll. We should check the bamboo thicket that the troll mentioned.
Some sort of tunnel, and there's blood leading to it.
Get back up here. That probably leads to where the demon lives.
I can feel a breeze. This passage probably leads somewhere outside. I'm gonna go check it out real quick.
Are you shitting me?
Stupid. Get back here.
Don't be an idiot. Unfortunately, this girl is as stubborn as she is stupid. So she's gonna go down here. Yeah, we can control Doro. We can throw shit, we can punch and all that good stuff. She is pretty awesome, I'm not gonna lie. She is a small child, but she's very agile. She's actually relatively strong, too. Okay, so crawling out of the tunnel here. We're gonna have some really fun little platforming segments here. And I'm not too confident in that, so let's go ahead and save up on a separate slot. Here we go. Good for you, Alan. Good for you. Unfortunately, it takes a little bit longer, but, you know, whatever. All right. Save it up. And let's not die, shall we? So, what are we going to do here? We got, like, all these spikes to deal with. Yeah, just some basic platforming nonsense. They won't instant kill us, but goddamn, they will hurt. So, just be a little bit careful. All right, no problem so far. Bait this thing to the ground. Then we can walk on top of it. Relatively straightforward. This stuff is going to get exponentially more diabolical, so, you know, what can you do? What, you know, makes me confused is fucking the fiend or whatever has to go through this area like every time. It's a little strange. Punch this. Yeah, we get a path revealed with just a simple little jumping puzzle here. And we made it our first try. If you fall down, it's not like instant death or anything. You just lose a wee bit of health and you have to redo it. It's kind of like Zelda. Oh god. These dogs suck. They like to throw... Punch! Throw fireballs at us. As you can see, Doro is a bad mamma jamma. Whoa, barely dodged that fire. Alright, can I could throw rocks at him. It doesn't really do too much damage. Oh, I messed that up horribly. Now I'm like poisoned. Doesn't do like constant damage, but it makes me a lot less dexterous, which is unfortunate. That's kind of Doro's strong point here. Okay. And a nice perk to playing as her is if you kill a lot of monsters, you can actually get stat ups. They just kind of drop randomly. You can skip by the monsters if you're not feeling cocky, but I do advise killing as many as you can, just so you can get those stat ups. And hell, I had to kill these guys anyway to get out of this area. Why the hell not? Break some statues. Invincibility? Oh, I forgot about that. That would have been nice to have against those dogs. Yeah, when you glow yellow, you're totally invincible. Completely impervious to damage. It's a nice thing to have. Well, let's ride this up and get out of this area. Again, the fiend has to do all of this bullshit to get out, which is kind of strange. Yeah, you know, what can you do? Hit circle. Gotta be strong, Doro. Why not? Now, where is this gonna lead us, viewers? Where? Eh? Yudai's bedroom? Huh. Very suspicious, right? Oh, well.
Someone's
we're gonna
there.
Get the hell... What?
Get him!
Huh? Yeah. Damn it! Let me go!
Tie him up and bring him to the East Town Square!
Yakumaru has decided to travel on his own. Yeah, Doro's taking too long down there in the pit where the fiend is, so we may as well move on, right? Not even, like, go down there and check on her? No, let's just get the hell out of here. I used up a lot of ammunition on that fight, which is a little embarrassing. I'd like to think I'm a better player than that. I don't know, that thing's really strong, man. It's stronger than anything we've encountered before, I believe is what Yakumaru said. So, let's break a few of these stone tablets before I try and escape this perilous pit. This dangerous, dark, desolate cavern. Couldn't think of a D word for a cave. Whatever. Grab a few bullets here. And I'm probably not going to smash them all. This is kind of tedious, honestly, and I'm just wasting time on the recording. What we need to do is follow the map. You can see the arrows up there. It leads to a blocked off area, but no worries. Just smack the hell out of it with our fake arm, and we are good to go. Onwards and upwards, and hopefully out of the cavern. Now loading. Where are we going, buddy? Yeah, we're in Yudai Village. Sweet. So we're going to explore around here tomorrow, and hopefully we can figure out where Dororo went. Otherwise, we need to head up north to the bamboo thicket. Yeah, there's a lot of bamboo up there. You can't really see it. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, viewers, and I will see you then. Have a great night.